Well, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome for to I guess this is our second team gathering virtual tasting, our first ever cooking demonstration. We're Correlation Wine Company meets Food Network meets just the talk show bantering as a team. So, oh yeah, that's right. We'll go after that in a second. I know I have this jacket, if you actually believe it, is this goes back to it's almost 18 years old. I can still fit in it. It's wine. The wine helps.
Hey.
It's not like cinched in around.
What is the talk show where people sort of they make fun of each other? There's
this one.
This one right here. All right, that's another challenge for y'all out there. You got to come up with the title for this new talk show that we've created.
Yeah.
And help by the sponsors and advertisers.
Perfect.
This is not cheap.
No. When we're getting steak like this, we'll come over to the camera for a sec. We'll get a little bit of a close up later, but
nice.
We have three different cuts of meat today. We've got the filet mignon, we've got the New York strip, and we've got the hanger steak, and we got two of each. We're gonna do grill. So I've actually already pre-grilled three of them. They haven't been finished yet. We'll finish them in the oven. And then I'm gonna, in a cast iron skillet, I'm gonna cook these ones right in front of you. But figure as, with the world around us, great opportunity to get together, still as unsettled as things are in the world, even us, our team, it's hard for us to get together on a regular basis. This has been, it's been a pretty crazy last week here in the Napa Valley. Thankfully, we're all safe. We're all healthy. Most importantly, they're drinking all the rosé without me. I guess that's what happens.
You have to stay hydrated.
It's very good to be hydrated with the rosé.
Summer water.
Here we are on the cusp of harvest. It's very thankful to look outside and see blue sky. The weather is cooperating. For any of you, and for those who may see this later, a huge thank you to all the first responders who really, it's unbelievable what they have had to endure this year, not just here in Napa Valley, in Sonoma, all over California. It gives us the chance to do what we do. As the winemaking hats start to get close to being put on for the season, we're getting close to look at what's ready in the vineyard. Stagecoach Vineyard, which is right up on the edge of where the fire was. We've been watching that closely. Thankfully got some sampling done yesterday. Been working very closely with their team and the samples that we got back from the results we got back from samples they took last weekend come back clean for any smoke taint, which is, thank God. So, if you can be literally, when I was sampling there yesterday, all the hillsides around the vineyard were burnt out. So to see that the fruit came out so far unscathed gives us really honest, great hope that this is going to be a great vintage. Because up to this point, minus what's happening in the world, the growing season has been spectacular. It's been a little warmer season. Probably leads to believe that when all comes to fruition, ready to harvest, we'll get there closer. Fruit will be fairly compact and it might be an all hands on deck, let's go. But in the meantime, we'll make sure we get a lot of protein in. The team will drink a bunch of rosé while I keep the chat. For those of you obviously on the list, we re-released the 2017 Correlation Cabernet last week, or 2 weeks ago, actually. And this was an offering, of course, that we tried to launch this spring. COVID put a hold on that as we weren't ready to ship it. And we wanted to get wines to you that we could ship, and hence the starting of the process of all these virtual tastings. So as we were brainstorming as a team last week, we came up with this great idea, steak and Cabernet. What a perfect correlation. So I guess without further ado, we'll sort of jump into it. But cheers to all you. Cheers to all you guys.
Is it okay?
If wine grapes are the only ones having a good 2020, we're going to take that as a win.
You got to find a little win somewhere.
Absolutely.
I think, for those of you who do or don't know my background, I mean, this jacket I'm wearing actually has a fair amount of significance, and it means a lot to me. This is really how and why I started in the Napa Valley. I think that, you know, before getting into the world of wine, I went to culinary school and finished my studies at the Culinary Institute of America, came out here part-time in 2000. I did an internship at the French Laundry with Thomas Keller, and this is actually my chef jacket from when I was at the French Laundry. Upon moving to Napa Valley in 2001, I ended up spending about another year and a half there, and as much as I wish I would cook more often, or actually maybe my team and my wife wishes I would probably cook more often, I like to say that I've traded my chef hat for the cooking that puts this in the glass. But today we'll see if the skills are still there. So, you know, obviously wanting to go, you know, one of our favorite markets in the Napa Valley is Sunshine Market down in St. Helena. It's small family market. They've been in the valley, gosh,
early 70s.
Okay. So almost, 40 plus years old. It is awesome market. Their meat market there is spectacular. The selection is amazing. And we went down and again, we knew we wanted to get a few different cuts. So we found this. This is called, it's from Heart Brand Ranch. They're actually from Texas. So this is good old American meat. But it's called, James might have to help, Akuashi. So this is basically, this is American Wagyu. And I'll read a little bit from what this says here. So the cows at Heart Brand Ranch, they might look conventional to the casual observer, but the livestock producer will notice one thing right away. They're red. The cows are red, not the usual black. The difference is in the hide, deep. The red beauties, Akuashi, they're one of the four breeds known collectively as Wagyu. And Wagyu simply translates to Japanese cow. And of the four four varieties of Japanese Wagyu, Akuashi is known in native Japan as the emperor's breed. So these are pretty spectacular cuts of meat. If you're not here in the Napa Valley and you're not near Sunshine, if you go to their website, heartbrandcattle.com, Lexi will put that up there, heartbrandcattle.com. You can actually order you can order their meat directly from them. So you don't have to just sit here and watch us eat this beautiful meat today.
We hope you can come to St. Helena and shop at Sunshine sometime soon and buy some steaks.
Exactly. Because we are, who knows, maybe there's a rumor that the governor of California might make an announcement on Friday. So we'll see if he grants us the opportunity to start welcoming guests back inside. We'll see. That would be nice. So I guess, as always, please use for those of you that are joining with, I want to see pictures along the way. Our team's going to show, you guys got to show the camera what you're doing. Tell us what you're cooking. Tell us what wine you're drinking tonight. Tell us what's been going on. Any questions you guys might have, use the chat function. And we're going to go ahead and get started. I've got, we made some roasted baby fingerling potatoes today. Those are going to go well with our dinner here, or afternoon snack, more like it. We've got some cipollini onions that I've roasted earlier in the oven. Just a little salt, pepper, olive oil, put in the oven for, almost 45 minutes, low temperature. I think that was close to 300 degrees. I have a 2017 Correlation Cabernet and Veal Demi-Glace Reduction that we'll finish off with a little truffle butter here in a little bit.
Oh my God. My way sweats.
Yes.
Do you want to smell the truffle butter?
Yes. Yes, I do. Ooh, my God.
Yeah.
No. Wow.
Don't hand that over to her. This is dangerous.
I already smelled it.
Maybe you take the top off.
I know.
So that's going to be pretty good. So obviously everyone's got their own style and how they like to cook steaks. Do you like to grill them? Do you like to sear them? We're going to do both today. So as I said, we pre-grilled some. We'll finish them in the oven here in a little bit. Seasoning is a whole other thing, whole other question. When it comes to me, I like my steaks very simple. Salt, pepper, olive oil. That's what I did for the steaks on the grill. Try to cook them to mid-rare.
Yeah, how long were they on the grill?
The grill outside here gets smoking hot. So that was literally almost like sashimi style, just mark them. So,
well, they're 2.5 inches each.
Yeah.
These are
thick steaks. These are not small steaks. So I'm going to get these seasoned up here, and then we'll start to get them cooked and start getting on with our afternoon. And I've got some other aromatics that we're going to put in the pan. I've got cast iron skillets back here that we're going to put it in. So I've got a little extra virgin olive oil that we're going to put on here. Like Julia Child. And here we rub the rub. That's for another virtual tasting.
You have to put in a credit card number to get into that.
Wait a minute, Wes. What are you drinking already, Wes? Because I know you've been drinking.
Yeah, exactly.
All the tequila that you have before.
There's got to be, they're drinking all the rosé.
You gotta give it a little flair.
Oh.
Put a little spin on it. Yeah.
A little salt there. No.
I really hope Chef Keller's not watching. You know.
That just went down my shirt. So.
Jess has that to look forward to later. Yeah.
Oh, dear.
I'm pre-seasoned. A little crack of pepper on these guys.
I wish we did this every day.
I don't think we'd never sell any wine if we did this every day.
Or maybe we'd sell wine if we did this every day.
That's up to you guys. Help make Lexi's wish come true.
We get to do this every day.
Every day.
Well, a big part of the joke is also everybody who's been to the winery, if you've ever seen our break room up at the winery, we've got a pretty spectacular break room that's sort of worthy of a CIA-trained French laundry cooking chef. And we always joke that Wes never goes into the break room, which is a professional kitchen, and cook us anything. So
now I'm gonna cook.
Yeah, this is the microwave.
All right.
However, we did make some amazing grilled cheese on some rosemary with the Toma cheese. It was very expensive grilled cheese.
Did we do that? I didn't.
Oh, you were there.
I didn't do that.
I don't think we told you that. So
you weren't
there.
Sure.
I don't think you mentioned that.
Well, we gotta thank Mom and Dad because we're using their kitchen today. So thank you, Lonnie and Weezy.
There we go. All right, get our pans nice and hot for a minute. You know what? I'm going to drink my rosé. I need some cab.
Probably time for some Cabernet Sauvignon that's not pink.
Mm-hmm. Bottoms up.
That's true. It was not telling a lie that we are still drinking Cabernet Sauvignon.
This is why we've got the cheese and charcuterie in front of us, because there's nothing better than rosé with that good stuff.
Correct. The last time we as a team were in this house all together, Lonnie and Weezy were here, and we were playing Cards Against Humanity. And
auction Napa Valley 3 years ago.
You can't tell the trade secrets here.
Weezy was hilarious and Lonnie was reading a book listening.
Saying, what are you guys doing?
That's inappropriate.
We don't need to say some of the phrases that came up.
No.
It's always the nicest woman of a certain age that gets the worst cards
in
that game.
It always is. Or the best.
Well, I've got a good friend who's a Montessori school teacher, and she's just the most pure as the driven snow, sweet, sweet lady, and it's always the BBD card that ends up in her hand. She knows she doesn't want to say it out loud, but she's got to say it if she wants those points.
Yeah, well.
All right, so.
Okay, our pan's nice and hot.
Pans are getting nice and hot. Again, as I said, I'm using some cast iron tonight. Make sure, quick next chance there, I do that. That's going to be really hot.
We're drinking.
And we have to shut this down. Chef just burned himself.
We're drinking 2017.
2017. So this is, actually the beautiful irony of the fact is that here we are releasing 2017 Correlation Cab, another year, of course, that Napa Valley and Sonoma was ravaged by wildfires. And in a year that we are facing similar challenges, but to see what this wine has come into, to see how it really, goes to show, you get lucky sometimes where the proximity is as to some of these fires. This wine, of course, from bottling was pretty closed down I opened a bottle earlier this week because I wanted to see coming into this. This wine is showing amazing right now. I was really excited to see how much fruit is showing on this wine.
I opened one last week and only had a glass out of it, and I just put it in the refrigerator and left it there for 2 days, and then took it back out, and the wine had opened beautifully.
All right, we'll put.
Listen for the
scissors. Oh yeah.
We're getting there. A happy sound.
That is a good sound. Any questions coming through? You guys got any questions along the way? Anybody cooking along with us?
If you need first aid, Wes, I'll be right up there to taste whatever you have on the stove.
Come on up. Come on up.
And we're actually surrounded on all sides right now by the vines that make it up this way.
That's true.
17, we've got Ashley right behind us. We've got block 4 right here. We've got the babies and 6 behind us.
Adding a little butter. I like that. So olive oil as well, but also a little butter in the pan. Helps bring the smoking point down a little bit. Gives a little bit of richness to the to what you're cooking with. As we get a little closer here, I'm going to start putting in some aromatics. I've got some garlic. I got some shallots. Try not to get tripped on my cable down here.
This chandelier? Wee, do you know much about this chandelier? We have some questions.
We can know everything about everything in this house.
I'm sorry, what?
Where's that chandelier?
There, I just found it, and it was a wonderful. I found it. I went and I thought, they're bottles and they're wine bottles, and it's really, really fun. And I don't remember who made it, but I can find out if someone is really interested.
Well, let's say you made it. We think we're
going to swap these guys. This is a hot one. There we go. All right, so cooking up here. Go for it. James is going to grab the camera. Come on in.
Yeah, I like the camera close.
Look at that. Got the filet down here. New York strip. This is a big steak. Put in a little thyme, more aromatics on the side here. And that guy is going to be just about ready.
The filet's probably going to be ready real quick.
Yeah, all right. So that guy's going in. And in fact, we should probably put these guys in.
What do you have the oven at now?
400. So those guys are going to cook pretty quick. We might have a little, there's going to be a little variance between when these are done, but that's okay. And then actually, one of the things you can do is baste it. Put some of that goodness on top of the steak. All right. Hey, ole, something fell. All right.
We're calling this, gender equity, the men in the kitchen and the women in the room.
There we go.
All right, so. Oh boy. We need some more wine before that happens. All right, so we got that in. I'll start heating up my saucy sauce.
So thyme, garlic, and shallots.
Thyme, garlic, and shallots. Usually do that with pork.
Oh.
Pork, lamb.
Chicken?
You can do chicken.
Lemon, or
the potatoes.
There are 900 miles of rosemary bushes planted all around us. We have lots of fresh rosemary. So now that smell, the thyme, garlic, and the elements, that's like walking into the French kitchen.
And maybe you can hear it.
Put that in there.
You can't hear it?
I know, I can hear Wes.
Oh.
Check the mic.
Who's that? There we go. What's
did
everybody?
You get the demi gloss at Sunshine too?
I did. So
you've not been up since dawn.
No, I do know how to, but I did not do it. So let's see. This is what I use here. So stock options veal demi gloss. There is no salt added to this whatsoever. This is pure veal. Veal and beef bones rendered, made a stock, and then reduced. So I had two of those that I reduced to about a quarter of one of those.
And then how much whey did you add?
About a cup. I mean, probably about a half a cup of one of these. So yeah, about a cup of wine. First I sauteed some shallots. Then I put the wine in. I reduced the wine down, cooked off the alcohol, get that bitterness out, but made sure not to do it too hot because I didn't want to burn the alcohol. I didn't want to burn around the edges. And then put the veal demi-glace in. Oh, Siri. Hey. Siri. Siri. Hey.
Pipe down.
The wonders of technology. Nobody's listening.
Nobody's listening. All right. So we got those over here. All right. What's our timing?
It is 4:26.
No, I'm thinking of my steaks.
Yeah, how long is the steaks?
Probably 3 minutes on the floor.
Thank you.
Oh, that's right. So there's a little interesting test you could try. So if you grab your hand, touch your thumb and pointer finger together, and you touch sort of the meat of your thumb right here. It's sort of really soft and tender. That's rare. And you're not putting any pressure on your fingers either. You're just touching them together.
Just hard together.
Then you do the next two together. Medium rare. Medium, and then to your pinky, well done.
Wow, that's so close.
So make sure you never, ever get to your last two fingers, because then you've destroyed very expensive food.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
So you
do it like this.
Yeah. We're still rare on that guy.
The beautiful thing about mistakes, you can always undercook it, and then that's actually the thing.
How are you preparing
mistakes? I'm gonna try to pull them out on a little bit more of the rare, medium rare side, and then we're gonna let them rest.
Because they keep cooking?
They will carry over. I mean, the smaller the piece of meat won't as much. Like, I mean, you think about like a turkey. If you're cooking a turkey, I mean, you could rest a turkey on the counter for an hour.
For an hour.
And it'll carry over. So, I mean, if you cook your turkey to an internal temp of 165 in the oven, you're done. Like, it's going to be sawdust by the time you eat it.
Because it's going to dry out. Yeah.
So I'm pulling my turkey at probably 155. Do you have one if you want one? There is a.
How do you not have a meat thermometer?
I've never had one. Because
Meg does this.
Yeah, she knows the phone.
Turkey is done because I'm the master. No, I grew up vegan. I grilled mushrooms my whole life.
Oh.
It's also possible to overcook the mushrooms.
Okay. So I need a whisk. We're going to find a whisk.
Wheezy, where's the
mom, whisk? Where do you put your whisks?
In a drawer.
Thank you, Dr. Obvious. Thank you, Dr. Obvious. All right, so heated up our.
Do you want a
camera
action for this?
Yeah.
Get it.
So, this stuff, Fabrique Delicacy Black Truffle Butter. Look at that. We'll give them a little product shot there.
Nope, nobody can see that. That was too fast.
All right, so a little whiskey whisk here.
Butter makes everything better.
Truffle doesn't help.
Yeah, the smell in this kitchen is not so bad right now. Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
I do hope that you all are eating as well as we are this evening.
Yeah.
Come on, we need a little bit more.
Say,
I need to save some for the pan sauce that we're going to do when the other stuff comes out. Because this
don't
is
worry,
the...
Mac. There's plenty for you.
Well, what?
You'll get
so some.
That's the look on Meg's face when she hears about Trouble Butter.
All right, so that is good and ready. We'll let that sit to the back here. Our steaks are probably getting close. How's the cab?
Great. Fabulous.
Is anybody out there drinking the 2017 cab tonight?
I'm drinking. So tell me something. Is James the only way the camera moves?
Correct. Well,
we don't have the studio team has the night off.
It's not on a tripod. So you
it is on a tripod.
Oh, move it closer. Move it. Zoom in on your. Move it. Yeah, bring it in.
Bring it in. Bring it in.
So I can see everybody. Oh, I'm getting a better view. Okay, a little over the other, you know, a little over towards James.
There you go.
This guy. There's another little trick. This little guy. And it'll rotate. This one.
Perfect. That's going to be perfect. Then I'm going to see everybody better. Awesome.
All right.
Hello.
Oh, who dinged?
Yeah.
Oops. All right. Chef's gonna get upset that my mise en place up here is not.
And there's no green tape in it.
That's the first thing I
have. You know.
Hey Wes, wait a minute. I thought you're doing the cooking. You got to be the chef.
That's true. I like to say for a moment that's true, but all right, I got to try this sauce over here. Oh my goodness.
No good.
Yeah, you got a pass here.
Yeah.
Pass that around. You grab that with your hand. Got it? don't drop the sauce.
I don't think she was going to drop it. I just think she wanted the idea of passing it on.
Oh my god.
What?
Oh yeah.
Truffle overload. Wow. That does not make me unhappy.
Yeah.
That is really lean.
Cabernet salt.
Yeah, there's. That's good.
That's going to be pretty good on the steak. Thank you, thank you. All right. We got to be getting close here. Let's check it again. Okay. How do you guys like your steak?
I know medium rare in New York.
I think medium.
How do you like moo? Moo.
Pittsburgh style? You like it Pittsburgh style?
Yeah, man.
My mother would go black and blue. She wants it so sort of raw and moo.
Exactly.
Oh, come on.
The
tougher it gets.
Choose from one piece that I just once you're still chewing it. Chewing
what
it
is that head. Rule? That's awful.
That's very rare. Like really rare meat, you have to.
Like bubble gum.
Not yeah. This stuff.
Yeah.
This stuff is so tender.
Maybe I'm just used to not. I'm used to mushrooms.
No, 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 no.
Very aggressive.
Really rare good meat. Melts in your mouth. It's like carpaccio.
I was going to say,
exactly.
Yeah, steak tartare or carpaccio.
That's rare.
It's raw.
I mean raw.
With an egg yolk, a quail egg, and some...
I cannot. Right. No, I'm also a texture person, so that's it's hard.
But if it's really good beef, the texture is going to be really, really good.
I will take raw fish anyway. I had my first oyster with...
You're not a carpaccio gal?
No.
Really?
I eat red meat probably like 4 or 5 times a year. And when I do, I want it to be really, really good beef, and I want it to be as close to raw as possible.
I think we're doing... This is why this couldn't work.
Yeah. Beef is not something we should eat.
Well, it's too bad. I don't think he was able to get on today, but I tried to convince our friend and local hockey player Brent Burns to get on because...
His cat is probably pretty close to where these...
That's actually pretty true.
He's in cattle country, Texas right now.
I mean, talk about somebody that likes red meat. That guy, Brent Burns.
Oh, he has a deer as a pet and giraffes, and zebras. Oh, not giraffes. Sorry,
I don't know if we're allowed to say that.
He doesn't have any of those things.
Never heard of him.
No. I don't watch hockey. He is a brick wall.
Yeah, he is.
Most brick walls don't have teeth.
So. Here we go. This one's coming out.
It'll bring it up.
Oh, that sizzle.
There we go. So that's the filet coming out. We're going to rest this baby over here. Oh, knock down the spoon again.
You put it on paper towel?
Just to rest it.
I bet you wanted to save the juices.
I have all the juices right here. Yeah, that's why we got to rest it. So that's going to go in the back. We'll make a little pan sauce from that guy. Which means we're going to assume that guy is done. So we got grill, we got saute on the left, grill on the right. The hangers and the New Yorks are, they're hanging on. They need to cook a little bit.
Will the hanger take as long as the New York?
It seems like it. Although the interesting part, I think sometimes with the Kobe style beef, it actually seems the texture, because it is so rich, it seems less cooked than it actually is.
Eric would like to know if the Wagyu steak appeared experience part of the future wine tasting.
Anything
that?
Can be
that
arranged.
That came out really weird.
I think we understood the premise of what's being asked there, and the answer is yes, Eric.
Sexy is a product of the St. Helena school system. So.
If that's gonna convince you guys to get out here, Eric and Stacy, absolutely, we will go down to Sunshine and get some more Akawashi beef for you guys.
Or
I don't think we need a whole lot of convincing there, Wes.
Or we drive to Utah.
We have talked about that.
You and your team.
Yeah, something. We got to get together somewhere. Bring the Wagyu. Bring the wine, Wes. And we'll make it happen.
Those guys are good.
That's a good time. We're itching to get on the road.
Oh, yeah. We're good.
Can you stop it?
We'll leave those guys right there.
Why don't we get the New York out and put it with the other?
Like with like.
Is there one where you don't even touch finger?
Yeah, it's your stomach. What does that mean?
What is the one
where and we'll get that guy over here.
Again, in the next 10 minutes while it sits there, it's going to probably raise about 5 degrees in temperature.
Exactly.
So, your question is very lucky.
We're going to get some of these aromatics out into this other pan. We got the chipolinis. Those are going to be good. All right. I don't want to get rid of too much of that good stuff. So, I guess technically I could add, if I had a little bit of flour, I could add a little bit of flour. But I'm not going to make a little roux.
Wine and butter. What else do you need?
That's right. We do need a little bit of wine.
Yep.
So, I keep forgetting to take this thing. So I go sear on the. Okay. I hope you guys all know the old adage that you never cook with wine that you won't drink. That old premise of saying that's crappy wine, I can just cook with it. Oh yeah. Yeah, you smell that sort of that. You smell the alcohol cooking off. You smell the sugars concentrating. We get our truffle butter over here. Get some of those yummy crustaceans off the bottom. It's not a crustacean, technically. We're not scraping shrimp off the bottom. That'll be for the Vineyard 7-8 tasting. We'll do lobster and Chardonnay. I like that. All right. And once I add the butter in, I usually take it off the fire because I don't want the butter to break. So this one's a little more wine based. Oh.
That smells amazing.
All right. So that guy will sit right there for a minute. All right. So in just a minute here, we're going to check and see if we got our temps correct. I'm staying away from our thermometer over here. I'm not going to do it.
What is your secret to searing steaks in the skillet?
Hot. Hot skillet. No, I mean searing. I mean the whole purpose of searing is sealing in the steak, sealing the juices. It's for a direct culinary turn. It's called the Maillard reaction. It is the browning. It's the caramelization of the proteins of the meat. And so that caramelization of the proteins creates this seal. Obviously, you're getting flavor with that, but you're also sealing in some of the juices. This part right now, is now technically, where did they go? So we can be properly compliant.
In case anybody works for the California State Department of Health, the Napa County inspectors, all food handlers.
We are in a private, I'm ServSafe certified. Did you get me small gloves?
Those don't fit me.
I can only keep these on for about 30 seconds before.
Do we have other sizes up there?
This is a hand tourniquet.
The good news is if he cuts himself, he won't bleed out.
You look like a Barbie with your hand, or Ken.
I can't feel myself.
You're still there.
Okay.
He put gloves on to serve the food.
Exactly.
Always need to have one. Yeah. All right. Let's see.
Let's get in there. No. Yeah.
Oh yeah. We did it.
We did it. We did it. Yeah.
That's the color of filet.
There it is.
I feel really scared of it, to be honest. No. I feel a little scared.
Don't have any.
I'll take some home to my husband.
Is that the
label.
Is that the pan or is that the
this
grill?
Is the grill.
Oh, gorgeous. Are we gonna do a little compare?
Mm-hmm.
Comparison. Okay. That's a sharp knife.
This is a sharp knife.
I didn't know what we have.
So we'll put that guy over there.
Love.
Because you respect the knife and the knife respects you. Which is why they don't go in dishwashers.
Oh, look at that.
I wanna sanitize it.
That's the color.
Is that better?
Beautiful.
Yeah. I don't know. I couldn't really see the other one, but I feel... We might need to have the camera close to my face while she tries to eat it.
Do you not like meat?
I grew up vegan. I don't know. I don't eat it all
she doesn't have a lot of experience.
Yeah. She likes ground.
Put your trust in our hands, Meg.
She likes the burger at Charter Oak.
That's true. See? That's usually okay. After a full bottle of wine, but in the to start with. Right.
Okay. We're going to... That's it's still a little bit warm.
We call it functioning around here.
All right. This is where you guys got to get... I'm tied to a cable over here, so you guys got to get creative with me on plates.
Oh. Okay.
I'll get some potatoes.
Potatoes,
potatoes.
Can you turn on the smell? Hey, can you turn on the smell button, please? I'm missing the whole experience here.
Zoom.
Scratch and sniff.
Zoom didn't get the update in time.
Scratch and sniff.
All right. So put that over there. Y'all need a cipollini.
Oh, look how pretty they are. What do you call these?
Cipollinis. Wait, hold on. Right, got another one.
It's a cipollone, multiple cipollini.
Oh.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, look at you.
It's Italian.
Our resident Italian over here. Or French.
All right.
The double C is a ch. That's the only thing I know.
Where I saw a little sauce dealio.
Weezy versus sauce dealio.
Okay. So this is going to be the. This is going to be the pan truffle sauce. The demi, I should do this over this.
Nice pour.
Okay. Just like, all right, so we'll have this here. And then I guess we'll do, we don't have a second sauce. We don't have a second sauce dealio, so. What's the. The giggling.
It's not been a while.
So this one, we don't have a ton of this one, so we got to make this one last. All right. So let's see what these other cuts look like.
Meg, can you see the blood on that cutting board?
Don't talk to me about it.
All right, so this is sear versus grill. Oh, yeah.
Beautiful. Oh, yeah.
I don't know about that one.
We could always pop some of it back in the oven.
We absolutely could.
Yep.
I didn't get any tail.
Did you eat all the potatoes?
Why does she have my plate in front of her, too?
She's eating all the potatoes.
Okay, so then we'll...
Of course, it needs to be redone anyway because it looks like somebody put four potatoes on those plates, and we all know four is not a seven or eight lucky number.
So. Winter is coming, and we need to bulk up to stay warm.
You know who did that? Winter is coming.
So I need to bulk up to stay warm.
Okay. So, you have a fork, you know.
Okay, I'm just gonna try a potato.
Okay, I'm gonna put this. So that is, let's see, that's grill, that's sear.
Yep,
okay. Grill, sear, we can tell a little bit of the difference from the top.
Behind
you. Okay.
Just say behind Chef.
Corner.
Let's see, how did we do on this guy? Actually, the New Yorks we're going to put back in for a minute.
Yeah.
The New Yorks are going to go back in for a minute. But that means we can get started on the other two. The New Yorks need a couple more minutes. Those are some big steaks. All right.
Them is some big boys.
So.
Two C's.
Yeah. Oh, two C's is a.
All right. So.
It's not Italian. You know, I still only have four
that's
potatoes.
That's sear. Versus not sear. Versus grill. Sear. Versus, oops, James gets to grill, sear, versus, no, you got to come back. I've got.
It's her first day. And her last.
Sear.
It's funny.
Versus
it's a
grill.
Joke, but I'm worried that one day it won't be a joke.
Okay. Grill.
Misses the
sear.
No.
Can you just filet
the first
can
one?
You, are
no,
there end
that's
pieces?
The filet.
Are
there,
are
yes.
Probably
so there's an end.
Okay.
That's sear. Mm-hmm. And this is an end grill.
Okay.
Okay. I'll put that over there. That one. That one. That one.
This
all right.
Is her first day.
Don't let me forget about
say,
the.
I'm not forgetting the New Yorks. We'll set
the New Yorks. Those will probably need probably three, 4 more minutes.
Chef, this looks amazing.
The Dyers would like to say it's impressive how long you've left this lumps on.
Yeah.
Well, he can't feel his hands.
Yeah, he can't feel
them. So.
All right, that's not happening. All right, we'll clean up the cutting board for Meg.
This was your idea.
I know, it was.
All right, did we, so.
I'm going to start with grilled food.
Which one's which? What is this one?
All right, I want a little sauce.
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Oh. You gotta try them.
I know,
three
I should.
Sauce?
But I'd need like 10 pieces of meat to try it the proper way.
That's true.
So,
okay, what is this one?
Here, that is
that's the
hanger.
Right, hanger.
Yeah.
Careful that doesn't fall over.
That filet is good.
Very tender.
Maybe if I just dress it up a bunch, I'll just really
it's like
enough trouble about
ranch on.
All right. Bon appetit, guys. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, that's a beauty.
Okay, so that was the grilled filet versus the seared filet here.
See, this one
is the seared filet. Just eat it. If I can do it, you can do it. I don't know. It's hanging on.
Well, it is a
okay. Those are both pretty spectacular.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna. I don't know. We can't forget to the purpose of this tasting.
See if it's any good
steak
with the
and Cabernet.
It's pretty bloody good with the wine.
What about this one?
You know, I do have to say when I do.
Sauce on, be
fine. When I do open.
Oh
jeez.
Don't
we have to
talk
about
it.
God.
So Meg is having
gravy.
She's having a truffle tasting.
Oh my gosh. I do find that I forget to drink wine with my steak. I'll pour a glass of wine, but I'll just be so excited about the steak that I'm not doing every. Right?
Yeah, that hanger's that hanger's pretty amazing.
Is it?
Look at my plate. That's my computer.
Billy.
It really would be my last day. Oh, your computer's at work? Bummer.
Bye. Oh, my cost saving.
Oh, the chipotle onion. Chipotle.
The hanger steak has incredible flavor.
Yeah.
Oh,
super,
yeah,
super good flavor.
Absolutely, Stacy. Absolutely.
What's the question?
We will bring the person who designed this kitchen to Utah.
Okay.
And then you can tell us who designed your backyard. We'll share. It's an even trade.
Yeah. Up the light here. All right.
Oh my God, the onion.
See how we're doing. So interesting enough, the grilled New York steak was taking a little bit longer.
I'm a big filet fan, but this hanger steak is so flavorful.
Well, hanger, so you know, for all of those who have been to Bouchon, the steak frites is the hanger steak with the
in France they call it the faux filet because it has more flavor and still tender like the tender thing.
We do a lot of skirt steak a lot at home. Skirt steak salads. Yeah. We do barbecue it, put it on salad or something.
The hanger steak is off.
Pretty amazing. I was not expecting that.
Wow. Sauce doesn't suck. Meg, is there any sauce left?
Truffle
helps
everything.
Oh my gosh. Hold on. Are leftovers included with the new cab orders? The diners would like to know.
Yes, fully on dry ice.
Case orders.
Yes, case orders only. Yep.
We'll call our friends at Heartland Cattle Company and we'll create a correlation here.
We've already partnered with the cheese company. We may as well have a bespoke cattle company now.
And pizza restaurant.
Is it bad that we're eating while we're sitting here talking with you guys? I hope that's okay.
Oh man. And the best part is
they made it very clear that there would be steak here.
They do that on Food Network, so. Mm-hmm.
Well, you never trust a chef who won't eat their own food.
Mm-hmm.
Or a skinny chef, right?
Right.
That's what I've heard.
Or skinny people.
Skinny winemakers are okay though.
There you go. Yeah. You lost me on one, you gained me on another.
Frankly, we need you more for the winemaking.
All right.
Onion.
So I think we're good there. So we're going to let those guys.
What did you do to the potatoes, Les? Did you steam them first or just put them right
in? No, raw, right from the pat. I mean, obviously rinsed them first. Salt, pepper, olive oil, and actually a little Dijon mustard. Chopped garlic, a little chopped shallots, and chopped thyme. Just tossed it all together onto the sheet tray. 425 oven for about a half an hour or so.
Explains why you shouldn't cut your potatoes before you roast them. Because the skin holds all the moisture in, so they steam on their own, so they get tender on the outside without sticking.
Mm-hmm.
I do cut mine, but now I won't.
Oh, yeah.
We'll never have a potato stuck to a sheet pan again.
I mean, roasted fingerling potatoes are quite easily the easiest side dish that you can make if you're just trying to throw something together.
But nobody's ever unhappy to see them on the table.
No.
Even vegans.
What's that?
She got a skinny because she spit some food out.
That's true.
Is anybody out there cooking?
She also has a really large head.
Is that
her
abnormal?
Jen, where are you? Jen, you said you're cooking tonight, aren't you?
Yes, we did cook.
You did cook. What'd you cook?
We had strip steaks.
All right.
Yes,
are they akawashi?
They first were sous vide and then they were cast iron.
Ooh.
Well played, Miss.
Well played, Miss Irish.
No, yes.
I like that.
Can't wait to see our strip steak.
So, Miss Jennifer Fortune Irish, who we were just speaking with, she and I go way back. Everybody, this is back to the days up in Geneva, New York, at Hobart and William Smith Colleges. So, there's a good 25 years of history between us. How she's still friends with me, I don't know.
She lives in another time zone. That
does help.
It's one of those miraculous things, like how you still fit in your chef's coat.
Can we make her wear the chef's coat now?
All right, that's it. Take it off.
All right. So he's not wearing anything under that. So.
I'm not. Oh, goodness, I got some schmutz on it. Chef. Is there something there? You can't trust a clean chef either? All right. Let's see. Oh, Billy.
That's a beautiful color.
Yeah. Don't show Meg. That's medium rare.
But didn't we ask for medium?
So it's pink all the way.
No, we never said medium. That's only before we said rare.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that marble. An end.
That is beautiful.
I'll give you an end piece.
Okay. There we go. See, that's. Well,
would you like some? Would you like some meat to go with your sauce? Have you co-mingled the sauces?
You co-mingled the sauces?
She lives dangerously.
Yeah, I'm.
All right. So this is the grilled New York strip.
That's the grilled, yeah.
This is the grilled.
Very evenly cooked.
All right. Mr. Imbach, pass me your plate across. I will.
Yeah.
Thank you, chef.
Waxy, one or two pieces?
I'll take one of each.
All right. So we'll get you. So this is the grill.
Well, what is this, the fourth time this year? Third time?
No, that's the grill. I got to cut the.
So you don't like rare meat?
I don't care for rare meat, actually, yeah.
All right, Meg, we're going to.
This is medium rare.
I'm going to cut this little,
I swear, my husband,
this little fat cap off.
I ordered a medium steak at a restaurant one of our first dates. He was like, this is not going to work.
All right, Meg, I'm going to.
Try.
Oh, perfect. Look at that. Medium.
That's medium. Well, that's close to medium.
That's close to medium there for you.
See, now that's doable.
Okay.
Yeah, it's the all.
That's pretty.
Yeah, that is not.
That's pretty well cooked.
Stresses me out.
So this is
tomorrow.
This is the pan. Lex.
That's
beautiful.
Yeah.
It benefited from a couple extra seconds in the oven.
Emmett says, we're going to do grilled strip shortly and take your simple prep advice.
And so wait, are you guys supposed to be meeting tonight, aren't you, Emmett? Isn't tonight the decision? Come on, Meg. Tonight's the decision, the breaking point, whether you guys are hopefully coming next week. It is relatively blue skies right now.
Yeah, it's right after this, and I think you've, I know Catherine's on. You've probably made our decision for us. Thank you.
Good. And we're if Meg can get back to her house in the next couple of days, that means Jake can as well. So
yay! We can't wait.
That'd be it.
Can I have? May I please?
I've been evacuated for 8 days, and I need to go back.
May I please have the little lovely sauce there? Thank you.
So hey, Wes, maybe we can talk you into cooking for us.
That, you know,
I'm liking that idea.
I would be happy to.
Wow.
I would be happy to.
Yeah, where are you guys staying? Where's Team Alabama going to be?
Hotel Yountville.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah, easy.
Right down the street.
Yep.
All right. So what's the consensus on the...
Okay, so I just tried the pan.
What's the last piece of meat you gave me?
That was the pan sear of the New York strip.
Oh, that was my favorite.
That's your favorite?
I think it's just because of the way that it was more well done.
What flavor?
I do have to say, though, from me not enjoying rare meat, you are right when you say...
A little more
say,
tension to that steak.
You're right when you say if it's cooked well...
Well, and if you start with really good beef, I mean, it's like you think about a sushi restaurant. If you trust your sushi chef, you know they're buying the best tuna.
Totally.
You know that you can trust that fish is going to be really pristine, so you don't have to do much to it. Considering the exorbitant ways in which these cows are raised and the extraordinary expense that goes into slaughtering them the way they do and bringing them out to California, No. You can't trust this meat. You don't have to do a lot to it. And being
exactly.
able to trust the quality of the herd all the way down to the last minute. I mean,
well, you mean you can taste. There's flavor all the way through. I mean, it's like a great wine. Yeah. It's sort of like a finish. I mean, it just keeps going and going.
Yeah, the New York, the strip has that really classic sort of mineral beef at the end. And
I got to say though, that hanger steak.
I think the hanger steak was a sleeper for me.
Like, I mean, that was a late call too. I mean, it was easy to grab the filet in New York. Those are the two staples you're going to grab. But when I saw the hanger sitting there and it was of the same akawashi, because obviously I wanted to do of like kind, I said, all right, give me a couple of hangers. Those hangers are spectacular.
I'm salivating.
What's that? You're salivating?
I'm salivating.
That's
I know.
Good.
I know.
What are you cooking tonight? Or what did you cook tonight?
We're having lobster rolls.
Oh, that's
because
you're not doing
because
you're not doing the octopus.
Yeah. Oh, I'm not. The octopus is out in the outside freezer, and it's not coming in the house.
How did we not know that Hishan has a fish shop?
I knew that.
So we could have been getting fresh fish from the East Coast all this time.
So does
Lonnie tell Hishan I want a copy of his catalog?
So does that mean you're drinking the Correlation Sauvignon Blanc with this, with your fish, your lobster roll tonight?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I mean, I'm hooked.
I am too.
So Wesley, I think you ought to send some of those recipes out to everybody who was on the video.
All right, we'll come up with it'd be easy to do. Be easy to do. We'll put information about where we got the meat from. So if you want to get it, a couple little. I mean, I'm not going to do like a, you know, how many, you know, teaspoons or tablespoons. This
You're
is.
You're going to say put the salt like this so it goes right into your shirt.
No, we'll give a basic list of ingredients that we use for today's tasting. We'll put it on a nice little PDF for you guys. And next Monday or Tuesday, look for it in your email. Absolutely, I think that's a great idea. And actually, we are recording this, so. I'm scared to watch it afterwards.
Look out for our YouTube channel.
This might be this actually will be the premiere video that we put up on our YouTube channel.
You guys may be the only ones who subscribe. It's going to be a lot of fun.
And for that, we love you. So, you know what? Let's let you guys go eat your dinner. We're going to go eat our snacks/dinner. Team Alabama, we can't wait to see you guys next week. I feel honored to be the first to know that we've coerced you into coming. And, you know, everybody, honestly, you guys, I mean, looking at when everyone was signing in today, you guys have been with us through all this, through all these tastings we've been doing, through these crazy last, gosh, almost 6 months that we've been having.
Yeah.
You're the reason that we get to keep doing this. So honestly, and not to sound sort of cheesy and heartfelt, but it is so true. It's because you guys that we fight. It's because of you guys that we get to do this. This is you're such a part of our correlation and everything we do. So thanks to you. And
hey, love you, Wes.
Thank you.
Love you, Wes.
Thank
keep
you.
It coming.
Love you guys.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh yes, eye contact. Eye contact.